No commercial break for the players. They started this one almost immediately, and off the start of this map, it was all Merc and Gaming. Cali was an assist away from getting his score streaks. Instead of rotating back, getting the capture points on the bottom lot hard point, they decided to challenge for the middle, and he got taken out just short, but he's been the only player going off. In fact, after he picks up that kill, there's the scoreboard. He is 12-3. You see Attach doing some okay slaying as well, 8-5, but at the start of this map, it's all Merc, man.
I'm liking the way that they're making this rotation. They literally rotated with about 30 seconds to go. Ares knew that as soon as they started to push up there, that Justice would start spawning towards the section where the, you know, where the second hardpoint hill is. And he's doing some great work, just managing to defend it and hold every single pretty much second down there. He's going to rotate away from it, not getting the last few seconds of scrap time. Have a look at that score, 63-10 already. Merkin in control. The hardpoint is contested. It wasn't any more just for a second there. Ares is going to push him. Wow, goes for the jump shot. What's going on there? Does pick up the kill. That was a bit.
Yeah, sloppy shots, but in the end, favors American Gaming. They're going to be able to control the hardpoint, and they have control of the spawn, so their lead is only going to get bigger, providing they pick up the necessary kills. Here comes Attach, making his way, gets their capture points around a third away to the score streaks. You see all of Justice, they're going to be fighting through Blue and Graveyard.
Yeah, obviously not having a good start here on Slums, but they of course can come back into this. We're only 7 minutes, only 3 minutes or so into the game, so they have plenty of time to come back into this, but it does look like Merkin are doing great work. They have just lost the spawns, unfortunately, but they are going to be pushing that blue streak, trying to push through there, and this is one thing that I really like on here, especially when you've got to keep in mindset for that last fourth hill. I like to see teams push through the third hill, try and get the scrap time on there, and then push around towards the anchor position and make sure that they get control of that ready for the fourth hill. So we'll see if they can do that or what their tactics is going to be for it, but Justice have already moved. I'm going to get control of this fourth hill on Garage.
Yeah, a bit of a late rotation from the Merkin guys, but they're going to fight from the old hill and try to take over the spawns. And it looks like they've done it, Chewy. So they can go ahead and take control of the backside. They're going to get their favorable spawns, and then they're going to work from there. But here comes a Hellstorm missile from Gucci. Looks like it's only going to pick up Legal, who is threatening to kill Gucci inside of the hardpoint. But the spawns, looks like they're still in control of Merkin. Actually, they got a split spawn. So they're going to be fighting from both sides of the map.
Yeah, they are indeed. Chino, the last one left in the hardpoint, does pick up a kill there. It is contested, does pick up two. Great work from Chino to be able to get that, and the scores are pretty much even. We saw Merkin with an absolutely dominant lead right off the start, but Chino and the rest of the guys from Justice have managed to hold this hardpoint now pretty
control.
Much the full 60 seconds, and they've got about 25 contested. Seconds on the last hill, I believe, or maybe even a bit more, and they've come right back into this game. Great work. Fear Looney managing to pick up that final kill. Of course, he is just a pickup for this game. I believe he's still on Fear, as far as I'm aware, and this is the last game here. Best of 7-0. And the score is 3-3, so this is coming right down to the wire, and it looks like this hardpoint game could be close once again. Looking at the scores, we've seen very close hardpoint games earlier on in the series, so
hardpoint
that way. I'm just having a quick look at the scoreboard, see what's going on. Already dropping 17-14, both Attach and Gucci.
And, you know, those are the two most important hardpoints on this map for a reason. Justice were able to take the lead, get score streak control, all of those two hardpoints. I mean, just fantastic work done by them. Gucci still has a lightning strike to use, trying to earn some more, but he gets shut down at the middle hardpoint.
Hard
and
point,
Justice, they're going to try to control hard the middle hardpoint, but they also have to fight for spawns at the bottom lot once again, as they're going to try to push through bricks, take control of the back table, set themselves up nicely for the next one.
Yeah, we did see the guys from Merkin getting a great amount of time on that first hill, but they've just got a horrible spawn. Actually, yeah, they have indeed, even though one of their players is down there. So Tipsy, I've just highlighted him on the minimap for a second. He's actually right down there in that anchor area for the second half point, but Looney got a horrible spawn. They've managed to push through. He's in this blue section right now, on board with Looney, as he does pick up a kill there in that double D section. Great work from him.
Hostiles,
he's
going
to get
hard
capture
point.
Points. Yes, he does. Notice that somebody's at the back. He's going to be able to take out that player. Lots of hit marking.
Ah!
They both need to reload. Just about does it. Attach went for the knife. Not going to work. Looney still not getting those spins though, which is surprising.
Yeah, that's because it's going to be Cali pushing down the street. They're going to take out Tipsy. They're going to take control of the hardpoint. Cali now around a little more than halfway, turning the Hellstorm missile. And they really need some score streaks as they're going to make their way to the next hardpoint, the white wall, the garage. They need something to take out that anchor point and take control of the spawns.
Yeah, and that was the problem that they had earlier on. They had such great control of the second hardpoint, but then as soon as they moved to the third, they did get the initial rotation over there, but it didn't work from then, and Justice were able to pick it up. So if they can try and find streaks from somewhere, it will come in big breaking things. But Tipsy gets a two-piece, actually, and it looks like they're going to try and challenge this, maybe. Interesting to see that the way that the Justice players have pushed up so far, even with such little time left on the hill, and Cali's already going to be the sneaky beaver in that back garage area, trying to get his team the good spawns ready for the third hill.
This would be great if they had a lightning strike dudes, because Kai could just push out right after it, immediately take control of the spawns, but unfortunately they don't have anything like that to work with. But You know, he's going to make his way in the back. It looks like he's done it just like that. Merkin are going to take over near the white wall. I'm going to go on board the new member of Merkin Gaming, Attach, as he's looking to do some slaying.
Yeah, this guy has been the slayer so far in the entire series, pretty much. Definitely been the one impressing us. I think that was a lightning strike that just came in from Gucci. Does take out two, taking out Legal and Kali, and they managed to take over control of it. Still on board with Attach, though. As soon as I say that, he does get taken out. Gucci's taken over the hill. He's on a 3-score streak at the minute, halfway to that Hellstorm missile. Merkin still have the lead, though, with 3 minutes and 11 seconds left on the clock. It's still a very close game, only about 20 seconds separating.
Gucci was saving that lightning strike for this very moment when he could use it to break the white wall. Now he's trying to earn himself another lightning strike around 3/4 away to getting the Hellstorm missile. If he gets his makes his way over to the garage, gets the capture points, he's going to be super close, but he wants to get the kills to do it. Finds two in front of Blue, only able to pick up one. No score streaks for you. In the meantime, it's going to be Tipsy driving his RCXD car along the map, but he's going to get a team kill, as that's just unfortunate circumstances. But Justice just took the lead.
Yep, they did indeed, and this is big time for them. They managed to hold down this Garage Hill so well earlier on in the game, so if they can do it again, they're just going to extend their lead. It looks like this could go down to the last hill unless players go absolutely massive, because these teams are just so close within each other. And look at that from Tipsy. He's able to earn himself that Hellstorm missile. Not able to earn himself a lightning strike, unfortunately. Merkin, have been able to break it. They're coming right back into this, but Revan, this is such a closely contested game. What is it between the hard points in these two teams? Like, it's just been completely close the whole way through, and pretty much every single hardpoint game.
Yeah, I think that's because they don't really have an anchor. I mean, if you look at both teams, they're just kind of running around their submachine guns. I mean, it's working. It's going down to the final second of every single hardpoint, but I mean, I definitely would love to see someone take out an assault rifle, especially Chino. I feel like it's just not been his usual self this series, at least in terms of the hardpoints. He's been playing great in the CTS and Certified.
Didn't he play incredible? I can't remember what he dropped in that. Didn't he drop like 38 kills there?
Yeah, with the SMG, but usually he's the one getting his team to spawn, which are so important.
Yeah, indeed it is, and they have lost. They have won both of them, but it has been incredibly close, and they've not been as dominant as they should be and would be expected to be on this game mode, as we do see Merkin in control of this middle high point. We've made two full rotations of it. Hellstorm missile is going to come right on top of his head, though. That was Tipsy's Hellstorm missile going to take him out. Still getting a reasonably good spawn towards that second high point hill over towards Blue. Merkin just behind, but only by 4 seconds or so. It looks like they could be getting the lead here. 23 seconds before we do rotate back, and they need to start thinking about that, Revan, because Justice are still getting the horrible spawns. As soon as I say that, though, who's that? Scoochie getting a great spawn.
Yeah, he's able to take control first team. That is so important, because Merkin, they've done some damage here on the middle hardpoint. They took the lead, but now they're fighting from unfavorable positions. If they just rotated back at 10 seconds remaining at the middle hardpoint, they could have potentially set themselves up for a win, but now it's going to be Justice taking control of bottom lot. Oh man, look at that spawn that Kali just got all the way back, Laundry. You know they're not happy about that.
Yeah, they are not at all, and I'm pretty much going to call that game, set, and match for Justice here, unless the guys from Merkin can go absolutely huge, just because the spawns that they keep getting, they have been able to take it over. As soon as I say that, Gucci does go big there. They're getting reasonably good spawns, with only about 24 seconds left. They need every single point, and that is going to be game, set,
it's
and
over.
Match, and the series. Justice are going to take it. They've taken, I believe, 3 maps in a row, or maybe, no, sorry, it was 2 maps in a row, I think they took. I can't quite remember.
Yeah, the CTF and then the hardpoint.
Yeah, they did indeed. They lost that Search and Destroy, of course, but they did manage to take it, and that came right down to the wire once again, an incredibly close hardpoint game. And this has been a really good series, actually, I have to say, Revan.
Yeah, going all the way to map number 7, couldn't have went any better. And once again, I think in all the hardpoints, nobody got 250 points.
No.
They all went the time limit. That's crazy.
Oh, it does indeed. And then with CTF, we've seen, you know, crazy flagpoles and stuff. We did see Merkin look dominant on both of the Search and Destroys, but, you know, both teams managed to take a CTF, and then the hardpoints were actually the defining thing, with Gucci pulling out 39 kills, 11 captures, and 11 defense. So he went huge. But the hardpoints that Justice managed to get all three of them were the defining difference in the series.
So congratulations to Justice. They are your Pro Scrim champions, with a narrow victory over Merkin, 4-3. If you missed any games tonight, head over to youtube.com/officialMLGCOD. They'll all be uploaded in about 15 minutes. But thanks for coming on for tonight's broadcast. Sugar, I love casting with you. Where can we see more of you at?
Well, I'm actually casting at EGL 11 this weekend coming up. I still need to book my trains ticket, so that's just reminded me. But EGL 11 is happening in London this weekend. That's going to be my next event. And make sure to follow me on Twitter and stuff, because I'll obviously tweet out when I'm casting again. But thanks for letting me on once again, Revan.
Yep, follow him on Twitter at @ESN_Chewy with 2 W's, right?
It's changed.
Changed. What is it now?
ESN. It's my gaming tag, actually. It's just okay. It's Chewy. No spaces, just it's Chewy.
It's Chewy. Go follow him on Twitter. get him some followers. But thanks for tuning in for tonight's broadcast. Make sure you tune in this Thursday at 7 p.m. Eastern. It's going to be myself and Golden Boy hosting the show. And you can catch all the action here on MLG.TV.